Hi, Alyssa here. Welcome. Like many, or rather most, in the world today, we have all had our normal routines thrown out the window. One normalcy that we had certainly taken for granted in our family is church. We used to go to church on Sundays. For my three-year-old daughter, this was an exciting event for her in the week, as she enjoyed and looked forward to going to her class independently and learning about our faith. We took a break from church, Bible study, and all of our regular activities when my son was born in October. We did this to avoid all the cold and flu germs we possibly could. My daughter had colds and viruses as an infant, and I realized it was much easier on baby and mom if we can wait until baby is a little older before meeting the germs. When my son was 8 weeks old, we made the decision to move just across town to a house that would better fit our needs. It was also Christmas, and our house sold by the new year. Imagine the inner and outer chaos that happens while packing and moving with an infant and a three-year-old. The following months were even crazier as we prepared to move, lived in limbo, hopping from our friend's house to my parents' house, as our new home was getting some renovations. Then finally moving into the house before the floors and the main level were put down. All while fighting what was probably COVID. Then, as we all know, the U.S. shut down in the middle of March, just as we were beginning to unpack boxes with two young children and no outside help because COVID. I was extremely stressed. My three-year-old was doing her best to go with the flow, but it was apparent that all of this change was taking its toll on her as well. We needed a light. We needed something special, something peaceful, something consistent. And so on Sundays, we have a tea party. We often make homemade paleo muffins, put on a record, and have tea. We talk, we sip. She eats stevia and scoops way too much into her teacup. She offers to pour milk into my tea. We use our best manners and our fanciest words, and we enjoy each other's company. We often spend quality time together playing pretend, doing puzzles, dancing, but the tea party is extra special because we sit and have intentional conversation on our best behaviors. It has become a highlight in our week. This coming Sunday, we are returning to church for the first time in nearly a year as the children's program is opening back up. We are so excited, but the tea party tradition is one that I don't want to lose. Perhaps we will move our tea to the afternoon. We'll have afternoon tea instead of a breakfast tea, and keep our sweet tradition of connecting and getting to know each other and enjoying each other's company, practicing our best manners and using our fancy words, and making the most of some peaceful time together in a chaotic and ever-changing world. I encourage you to make the most of the peaceful moments you share with loved ones. And if you lack peaceful moments with the ones you love, find a way to create those moments, especially with the little ones. It is a gift to connect with a child when they are feeling loved, tended to, and rather fancy. They become their best selves when you are giving them your best self. I'd love to know what traditions or moments you've been able to create during this strange time. Feel free to share them in the comments below the video. As always, remember to live honestly, and I will see you soon. Thanks for watching.